Hi, my name is Peter Kincaid. I'd like to take a few minutes to show you what the SCM high-speed engraving system was capable of producing. Here we'll be demonstrating a simple engraving technique with a fleur-de-lis pattern on the flat piece of wood, just to give you an idea how easy this system works. With a gunstock engraving, of course, you'll be working a curved surface, but it's good to practice on a flat board like this. You can pick the design you want, lay it down, and here all it is you just peel it off and apply the transfer system, which allows you to use either any pattern of your choice. It applies real nice. It's got a low tack, the adhesive isn't as sticky as on some transfer systems, so you can pick it up, pull it around, just have your handpiece there. Choose the bit of your choice. This is the number 16. You just point it into the wood and you'll be able to push it in. Make sure it's in firmly. Just get your handpiece set. And all it is you just want to be able to get an idea of how you're going to be carving around the lines. You want to work with the natural flow of your hand, but just kind of get an idea of where you'll be working with the system. The speed of this system allows you to go into almost any hardwood, actually any hardwood for that matter, like you're going into like a nice soft piece of caramel or chocolate. The speed of the system here is 400,000 RPM, which allows you to cut without wanting to grab or pull away, what some of the lower speed systems will do for you. This allows you to just pull right along through the lines, cutting really easily, makes a nice clean line. You'll be cutting generally around an eighth of an inch into the piece. You can vary that as you do that. Certain pieces you want to cut a little deeper, some a little shallower, depending upon how you will be finishing up this piece. Just follow the pieces around. You can trace the lines, or sometimes you can actually go along the outside if you're going to be just removing the background. That way it leaves the design itself more intact. You just follow your pieces around. Always try to follow with the natural curve of your hand. You know, pull curves back in towards you. Small pieces are a lot easier to work with. The positioning of your hand is really what feels comfortable for you, but just you always want to be sure to have the piece for an initial cutout of the design more or less upright or straight up and down, just because it gives you a flatter edge and a much easier edge to work with, and you're not creating or you're not undercutting the design as you come through. As you can see here, the speed allows you to just really just pass through the design so easy and so fast. It's really no strain at all. Here you can see that as you burn through the design, the stencil will fuzz up. Now, just so you're not panicked, what that is actually the stencil itself burning. The wood has a very sharp finished edge to it, so you really have to do no finishing work to it. And here you can see as you pull the stencil off, everything comes off real clean, real simple. Some of the smaller designs will sometimes trap a little bit of the transfer piece in there, which is just scrape off with your fingernails. And it's really a really nice system. You don't have any really high gummy stuff or residue to remove later. The finish is done, and either you can leave it here. Sometimes some designs will have just an outline to it, whether it's, you know, a simple outline of a bird, animal, or whatever. Or you can go to a nice scroll pattern like this, or sometimes another design, and you can see that as you pull the stencil up, the design is basically done. And from here, anything you want to it is more or less embellishment. You can either deep relief the design itself into the piece, and you can see it's really nice. It allows you to cut a border around it, either finish the piece up as it is. You can see in some woods will actually burn or leave a real dark color. You just don't want to hold your hand too slow in one position, because then you can actually burn a good amount of the wood sometimes because of the speed of the piece going in. And from here, we're going to be just doing a relief carving around the design, just to kind of bring the design itself up. And here we go to the number 9 bit, which is a round carbide, and just go in and hog out or remove the wood on the outside of the design. And it cuts so sharp so quickly, and yet it's not going to be grabbing or pulling into the design. The skills involved in something like this really are just, it's more or less like coloring or tracing a line with a pen, because you're just going in, just take out the stuff you don't want, leave the stuff you do, and it's essentially done. The piece here, as you can see, you can go in basically as more or less as far as you want. Some pieces will require you to engrave in farther or create more of a depth of relief to it. That's pretty much your your idea or the customer's idea of how they want the design to be finished. You can cut a hard border all the way around or leave kind of a, like, hand-hewn design like you did it with chisels or something like that. Of course, if you'd done it with chisels, it'd take another 6 or 8 hours. And it's just really sweetly moves through the piece. I mean, this is just such a short amount of time to do. And when you're through, you know, when you're through with this, you can either go back in with some diamond bits and create a really smooth background to it, or even just carefully use the bit itself and just kind of clean up, or just leave a little bit of texture back there just to get give it a nice country or hand-done look. It's preferred by some customers because it gives it a nice kind of a homey feel to it. The skills involved in this are really negligible. If you write with a marker or a pen, essentially you're ready to go. The size of the handpiece is essentially the size of a Sharpie marker. And from there, it's just a matter of doing what you want to do with the piece. Whether, you know, real intricate designs like this, some of these can you can actually go farther than this with a nice carved relief look to it. A simple back relief like this. It's really up to you what you want to do with it, which is really the nice part of the system here. And here, all you need to do is, when you're done with the piece, remove the frisket, and then choose your stain for the background. You can either have a lighter stain, so you're having the current color of the wood in there, or you can use a darker stain to kind of highlight the piece that you've done for the customer. And it's essentially just grab either a rag or a foam brush like this, soak it up, push it over the design. Some pieces, on some gun stocks, you want to be a little careful if it's got a high gloss finish, because some companies will want to cover their flaws by putting a thick finish on, and a rag sometimes will rip a small edge up on a smaller piece there, like an island. So you want to be kind of careful and just kind of dab it in instead of brushing it across. If you got a smaller intricate design, you'll be able to tell when you start doing the designs where you need to look for little trouble spots. But really, there is no problems. Oiled finishes are great. And then all you have to do is just wipe it off. The finish will protect the gun stock itself, and the oil or the stain will just soak into the air. Here's a finished product. It's done. There's no sandpaper involved. And that's it. Here we're going to show you a little deep relief for 3D carving for a piece. We'll use an acorn on the pistol grip area of a gun stock. And all you do is do, just like we showed you previously, do an outline with a transfer piece of paper, or you can even freehand if you want. Then here, they go in and I'm going to be removing the wood to give a rolling effect, a nice rounded effect to the leaves to give a nice 3D look to it. Gives a nice warmer feel and kind of a natural look that hopefully will flow with the gun stock that you're working on. And all you have to do is just follow the lines, pick which areas you want deeper, which ones you want lighter or higher up, and just carve accordingly. You always want to be sure to leave some areas, especially on the edge of the design, that are flush with the edge of the finish on the gun, because you don't want to have a sharp edge that's going to grab either flesh or clothing on the gun, or that could possibly chip or break off if they would happen to drop the firearm or whatever it is you're carving at that point. Other than that, you can pretty much do what you really will make the piece look the most natural to you. And then once again, you can either go back in with diamond pieces and smooth everything out and get a real nice finish to it, or give it that kind of the rougher look. You also can, with the system, after you stain the piece, if you look at it and certain areas just don't look right, you can always go back in, smooth something out, erase a couple lines, you know, change the design so it looks good, and then restain it, and it's not going to be a big problem because you're not applying layers and layers of stain to the finish or to the exterior part of the gun stock. It's just in the design you're working with. And because here it's carver relieved and it's got high points and low points, it's not going to show, which allows you, kind of gives you a fudge factor, I like to call it, where you can kind of cover up your mistakes and nobody's the wiser. So you can always remove high points or where you would happen to like go across a leaf and it looks kind of odd. And it's just go up and kind of clean up and finish up what you're doing and have a nice finished piece for it. And it's so easy to do. It takes no, you don't have to be an artist to it or have years of, you know, training. It's something that just, you kind of know your market, which is always nice, but it just works so well. Here with an antler, or with the antlers on a white-tailed deer, you always want to be sure that the design you have makes it look like a whitetail, whether it's, you know, or if you're getting a mule deer, make it look like a mule deer. The anatomy of the animal can be really brought out by relief carving. You can bring out the musculature of the animal, give it a flowing line of the fur. If you want to make it look like an older swamp buck and kind of a rougher fur, you know, it's really up to you. Here's a nice maple leaf design, which is one of the things that's nice about the system. You can adapt it to your area where they have, you know, more of a conifers or pine trees in your area, you can adjust it and have the design as you like it. And it's something that anybody can do. Now here's a nice round that was finished ground, simply using the diamond bits to smooth everything out, get rid of the engraved, the lines that you had there as you were cutting the piece out, and yet it has a really beautiful look to it. It looks like a sheep. You can see the horn and the depth of the horn on this side of the sheep, and you can see it kind of gives it that depth of the horn on the other side of the sheep, so it looks like it's sticking out farther than it is. Now here we've got a nice simple leaf design on the pistol grip area of the gun stock. This is all done, again, simple, just outline it, cut away, and then use the diamond bits to go back in, smooth everything out, get a nice warm, smooth feeling to it. So it's got the stain of it, so it has the same color as the stock. It's something that you can be proud to pass on, or, you know, give to a friend or a relative. And here with the feather design, this can cover over an existing piece of checkering already on the foregrip, and nobody will know, be the wiser. It'll have a nice feel to it. There's not going to be any sharp edges that could possibly rip if it's a higher recoiling firearm. And yet with the deep back cutting here, it looks like it's on top of the stock instead of being part of the stock. Now we have other techniques that you can use, whether it's just straight and relief carving. Some people even like to paint the design once they've actually carved it out to give it more of an enhanced feel or to have it stand out from the stock a little bit more. And even there, you can carve just or paint the particular piece or the whole background to it. Designs that quite nicely because they've got a large amount of books that are available that have copyright-free designs that it's more or less Xerox it, put it on, and go with it. There are also additional training videos that are available from SCM. They're there that can help you out immensely, and it makes it very easy for you to use.